So we are a threat light. We just have this treetop village in the way of pressure, which is not much pressure. On the plus side, the two disruption spells that we do have are pretty strong here. So some scouts and a spider umbra. If I was playing a deck with Liliana, I would consider taking a scout and leaving him with the other one. As is, I'm going to take this Rancor. Then I'm going to Abrupt Decay that Umbra and hope that I draw some amount of disruption to slow him down in the meantime. Yeah, just gonna play Verdant. Fetch for a basic forest when he goes to enchant. And Abrupt Decay. And then either Treetop Village or Godless Shrine on my next turn. Not the most impressive Abrupt Decay of all time, and it's possible I should be saving it for a more high impact enchantment. But this does prevent him from playing like a Daybreak Coronet or something on it. And when we saw his hand, there wasn't another enchant creature in there. I think this is defensible, the line that we just chose. I think this is fine. So he's just going to play his other scout here. I'm going to, once again, wish I was playing the Lingering Souls version of this deck with Zealous Persecutions. Okay, Tarmogoyf's not bad. We can go Tarmogoyf, probably Treetop Village. And then next turn, just fetch a white source. Tarmogoyf's a 4-5. 4-5's pretty large. I wonder if Bug is playable. Like, we have Tombstalker. We could play, like, Serum Vision, Sleight of Hand. I don't know. I guess there's some tension between Tombstalker and Treasure Cruise, huh? It's not like him to track in the format. But then again, it's not like Bug needs him to track. And holy crap, that's an Engineered Explosive. Do I just do that? Is that just way better than Seed Rhinoing? He's only got one card in hand. I'm pretty sure that's just way better. Last time I was like, should I disrupt him or play this thing? Now I just died, so this is currently one. Yeah. I'm just gonna blow that now. Pumps Tarmogoyf, clears his board. So now he needs so many things to go right in order to win this game. I don't think it's very likely, because we've got, I mean, our pressure is pretty strong. We got a 6-7 Tarmogoyf. We got Siege. Oh my god, not that card again. He is Hellbent, so if he's gonna go kill me after untapping, it'll be even more impressive this time. We got two treetops that can attack next turn, and I'm at 21 life. To all intents and purposes, he looks very dead. If I was him, I mean, he has to take this. He has to take this and go down to two. He's fetching it right now with the Verdant Catacombs. Probably just to put another Temple Garden into play. Well, no, he's chomping with a Dryad Arbor. That's acceptable. Yeah, when you're playing a creature combo deck like this, having a Dryad Arbor to fetch up and put a pile of Rancors on is pretty nice. Everyone that watched my Swift Spear Berserk video last week will share that sentiment. So the difference between this game and last game is that he doesn't have as many mana sources in play and not as many starting cards in his hand. I don't think he can actually chain cards together to come up with anything relevant here. And there's no way he could get enough of them. Yeah, just a Razor Verge Thicket, and he's just super dead. So we're still drawing this Ram card. I'm kind of questioning it. What if I just played like a pile of Mana Dorks, and instead of playing Doran, just like more equipment? like some sort of feast and famines, just like every kind of equipment imaginable. That seems actually kind of sweet to me. Okay, and he packs it in. Cool. On to the finals. I think we got a little lucky, but then we also have some very relevant disruption in this match too. And his deck is prone to stumbling, so that's not like a an absurd representation of the match. I don't have as much respect for Boggles as I probably should. But even if he had like a nut draw in that third game, Engineered Explosives would probably just won it for us. I might want a second of that card. But I mean, that was the best matchup for it, so it's going to look really good. Anyway, to the finals. Finals hype. Woo!